To a 2012 survey conducted by the Education Department, 74% of students claim they have been victims of bullying, while in the past, students only had their parents and themselves to rely on. That could soon change.
Well, that's right, Stanley. Congress has approved the Anti-Bullying Act, and it's now awaiting President Aquino's signature. To tell us more about the measure and the realities of bullying, we're joined in the studio by the bill's principal author, Congresswoman Mitch Cahayon, and Joy Cannon, a psychologist who also runs her own school. Good afternoon to you both.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
It's interesting how fast this measure has moved, considering it's a first in this Congress.
Yes, only in this Congress, and we're happy and fortunate that the Congress easily passed this. Unanimously, they have agreed that we need to pass this kind of bill.
But again, initially, this measure, the reason for pushing it to begin with.
The reason of pushing it because we need we see the clamor, and we see it's so timely and relevant. As we all know what happens around us, there are incidents of killing the perpetrator and the victim, something like that. So the need to pass this bill, we see the relativity and the timely. It will be so good if we pass this kind of law.
How does Congress define bullying?
Bullying is a severe and repetitive act of teasing and also this kind of act, like if I may mention punching, pushing, shoving, kicking, tickling, and headlocks. So these acts are no, and also in cyberbullying. We also included cyber and any electronic bullying is also included in this.
But this piece of legislation primarily focuses on schools and students.
On schools only and students.
Very contentious, repetitive. So if I do it only once, it doesn't
it
count.
It doesn't count. It must be repetitive. And if the perpetrator is already this giving destruction to the education of the one that has been bullied, that included on the punishment.
And by repetitive, someone has to keep count.
Yes.
So this should be reported.
Well, not really. If the one that has been bullied already make a complaint.
Okay.
Of this incidents.
Anywhere in that definition included public embarrassment, or is that the result?
I think that's just a result.
Because if that's the case, then is there any room in this measure that you would also accommodate or bring in incidents involving parents, for example, publicly humiliating a child?
Yes. Well, actually, if it involves parents already, well, actually, it is the school that has to make the design the policy on how to deal with this kind of incidents. Like, for instance, if I may point to Teacher Joy, who has been handling this kind of situations, I admire her because how she handles these things in the school, she handled it in a way
actually
that
probably sensitively.
Yes, and the school has to be sensitive because of the parents and students' need of handling this kind of.
Probably, let's go into that.
Maybe asking Teacher Joy used to handle these cases, but now you're legally bound.
Technically, yeah.
So
I think the law will allow schools to really think about policy. You know, one is I think any educator should focus first on building a culture of respect, because as I was telling Congressman, that the antidote actually to this whole culture of bullying is really to begin with building that strong culture of respect, which we try to do in schools. Now second, what the bill allows is the mechanisms to help children. So if there is a clear mechanism in terms of how do you report, how do you bring up a concern, how do you get help, both for the child who feels that they're being bullied and for that child who may be bullying. And the child may be bullying for some reason, right? It may be issues of power, issues at home,
problems
and you also need to help both of them. And so, with a bill, it allows to for schools to clearly articulate how to go about doing this.
So it's not kicked out right away.
No.
There are
no,
protocols of stages. Can you walk us through the stages?
Yeah, and it would, I guess, the bill is open enough for schools to think about the respective policies. Mm-hmm. But normally, you also have to take these things in the context of development. Mm-hmm. Now, as I was saying, a 7, 8, 9-year-old, they will really be playing around. Yes. And, sometimes you get kicked by a ball. You don't want kids to say, oh, you're a bully, You want to avoid that. So, proper education, I think, for kids. What is really a bully?
Being the case then, and before we get into the process included in the measure, maybe let's understand that culture. What is it really that drives children to bully? Ano yung mindset ng kabataan para pumasok sa ganung klaseng behavior?
Some kids, there are many things that may contribute to that kind of behavior. One, it can be attention getting. Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe kids who lack attention will enforce themselves and try to get attention with other kids in an inappropriate manner. Okay, sometimes it's simply lack of social skills, mm-hmm. that they don't really understand how to play safely and how to play well. Okay, but sometimes it is also an issue of power.
Right.
Okay, that maybe in their lives they have no control over other things, and in this situation I'm in control, and that gives it, that feeds into that. Yeah.
And what's the typical profile naman of the bully?
Victim.
One of the things that we work really hard in our school is to empower children with an I message. Okay?
I message.
If somebody does something to you that you don't like, you have to immediately say, I don't appreciate what you're doing, please stop. Or I don't like you hitting, please stop. I don't like what you're saying. So immediately, the person who is bullying or doing something towards the child that is making this victim uncomfortable is immediately aware, okay?
That limits.
Yes, stop. No? Mm-hmm. And I think simply by installing language for children, it already empowers them to protect themselves. Okay, because some kids, if you don't teach them how to do that, to assert themselves in a positive manner, if one child does a behavior towards them in a negative way, some of them will just cry, some of them will just complain,
fight or flee.
Yeah, or some of them will fight back. No, mm-hmm. So to create that kind of culture, to truly be a bully-free school, you have to start with culture building, proper awareness among kids. And what I like about the bill is that it involves not just the school, it involves parents.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think parents should share the same understanding, because you don't want parents to, as you were saying, if a child just does, slightly pushes another, and then the schools will deal with so many parents just saying, this child's a bully. But it's not the case. The bill is very clear about it being very severe and very repetitive, to the point that it really causes maybe psychological difficulty for kids. And I agree with Congresswoman that as a school, you don't want children to feel that school is not a safe place.
But do you feel that ordinarily schools are well-equipped to deal with these different cases, or are they completely not aware and helpless given those situations?
Well, actually, with the bill, if this will become a law, schools are required to, especially those who will be a guidance counselor, required to undergo training. Mm-hmm. That's why, because this is a special case. Bullying is it says in the bill that parang it appears that bullying is a special case. That what Teacher Joy have said, it might before you bully, the tendency to bully sometimes you have may pinagpukunan ka. Mm-hmm. So baka there might be a problem in that
sa bahay,
or you have something that you cannot release, di ba, emotionally in the house. That's why there's tendency of bringing it sa school. So parang this bill is designed really sa school na parang to require a special training for those who will handle these cases. Their school, there is a child psychologist really that handles these cases. So we will be requiring even the public schools to have such kind of training para lang to focus on this kind of cases.
That's training on handling bullying cases. But what about the monitoring side?
Monitoring is part of it. Part of it.
Kasi
part
of most it. Of these incidents don't happen inside the classroom. Oh, sometimes it's in the hallways. It's so hard
maybe
to substantiate.
No?
Tapos when they report to teacher, sometimes it's your word against mine.
Actually, once, parang it will be a case na for them. Once it is served on the desk, parang it will be a case monitoring for them na parang with the involving the principals na parang ito, for example, we have this case. So it will be monitored and it will, the beauty of this bill, the perpetrator will undergo a series of parang rehabilitation. Something to that effect.
Do you have a case, a sample case perhaps, if you will?
Okay. Our school, because our school is a progressive school, no? So, and its core framework is multiple intelligences. So, because of that, you allow children to have a culture of respect. So, part of the mission vision is the core culture of respect. So, in all the years that I've run the school, we don't really have a lot of cases in our school in terms of bullying, no? And but when we interview kids who want to move into our school, okay, I hear a lot of these stories, no? And the reason is we want a different environment totally that's sort of bully free. And that's why I think I was asked to come in, because you also have to think, this is the law that is protecting us, but also what can we proactively do in culture building in schools? And I think over the 17 years that I've run the multiple intelligence school, it's sort of really been a sort of a, in a way, bully free in a way, okay? Because kids can empower themselves, and then there's a good parent-teacher relationship. So you immediately are able to give feedback.
Yes.
Now, if you look at this as a sort of a model, and you hear about the kids, no? I hear about kids, for example, I ask them, why do you want to move to our school? Because teacher, I come home sometimes, their shoes now, no more shoes. I go, what happened? Because when they play PE, when they have PE, sometimes keeps their shoes, no? Or just the other week, a parent was coming and saying, teacher, second day pa lang of school, I'm thinking of transferring my child to your school. I go, why? Because eating daw, the child was eating in the canteen, and somebody just came over and just poured ketchup over the food, no? And so I said, but how do you, you have to teach your child, no? To use ways to speak to this other child doing it, no? So first, find out muna, is this child trying to be friends and it's a wrong way of being friends?
Calling attention.
Or second, I go, you know, he should show that he's strong enough and use humor and say, oh, you poured ketchup in my food, you must like ketchup, eat my food. I mean,
yes.
Something like
yes,
that. So
yes.
Just so that the child doesn't show that he's really a victim. And because, you know, bullies like people who do not fight back.
Right. Nah? Right.
They like kids who will be just quiet and really not. Mm-hmm. So if you want, as a parent, to help your child, is teach them really to assert in a positive way, no? Because you don't want them fighting each other, no? So you want them to assert verbally, not physically, in a positive way.
And you wouldn't want to rear bullies either.
Yes.
You want to be able to make sure they behave properly in the company of other kids.
If I may mention one of the provision of the bill, it says there, it also educate parents and guardians about the dynamics of the bullying and anti-bullying policies of the school and how parents and guardians can provide support and reinforce such policies. So it is not only the school that we are trying to get involved with in this bill, but also the parents
as well.
It's
quite complex because we're looking at a complicated family culture.
Yes.
Kasi,
di ba,
in some families, okay lang yung batok-batukan, and then we bring to school.
Yes.
So parang it
tough
opens
love.
A lot of...
Well, if that is being practiced in at home, not in school.
Mm.
Because others, as you said, coming from different cultures, not for other students, because it for them it might be hurting already.
What has been effective with us in terms of that? Because it's true, and you cannot tell a parent how to parent their child, no?
Mm-hmm.
But we advocate as a school, like at the beginning of the school year, right now, in the next 2 to 3 weeks, we really talk to parents about our positive discipline. And we give parents also tools so that if teachers speak to your children in a positive way and get the discipline across, maybe parents can try it out at home. And what I realized that because there's really no parenting university, so there's really none. And so I found a very positive response among our parents. And in fact, if teachers speak in a positive manner to achieve the discipline, parents slowly shift their practice, no? So if the dads before who would be quick on the, you know, okay lang naman yan, ano, pwede naman yang mapalo or whatever, just don't spoil the child. after a while, they evolve because they see, there are other tools naman. No? This may have worked, but if I try other tools, maybe it's a more effective tool. So it's really, what I like about it is that there's really a strong provision in the bill for education. Mm-hmm. That you educate the children, mm-hmm. you educate your faculty, and you educate your parents, no? Mm-hmm. But very complex, as you said.
And interesting that you've also brought in, education is one aspect of it, but you were also mentioning leading up to possibly along the lines of remediation. Mm-hmm. Yung process for complaints for the child, that has to be open as well, yeah. And they have to know where to go.
Mm. Yes, yes, mm. yes. Actually, there are some cases that the child might not talk about it. Mm. Mm-hmm. And he might keep it himself. The problem is if there is also someone who is concerned with the situation, it could also be entertained. Mm-hmm. So if the child is not, if his character is not really outspoken of what he is undergoing,
somebody should speak for him.
It will be valid. The documentation will be up to the schools. Kasi for ordinary yes. crimes, okay, halimbawa, yes. you go to the police and you get a police blotter, for instance.
Well, the law enforcers are also involved, but somehow the penal code is provided for them. It is
but
also
they,
in the...
Are they still required to do that, to go to the police first, or the documentation of the school will suffice?
Well, no, the documentation of the bill is suffice. Mm-hmm. Because it is really...
Because I think the spirit behind it is really that you want to keep skills. Kids in school and schools should still always advocate for a safe place of learning psychologically, physically, and so if these needs are addressed, the goal is not to be punitive to either the victim or the person bullying, no, but rather to give enough measures to ensure that both parties are helped and continue on to the in the educational ladder in a positive manner.
Actually, there's also urgency to this because as we've seen in many cases or stories, mm-hmm. and it's come out in the news,
yes, yes.
it's not as simple as a case of bullying where it ends there. Mm-hmm. You're talking about victims taking their own lives, mm-hmm. and that's probably the worst extent we've seen
yes,
so far.
Yes, yes, yes. That's why if the bill will become into law, we will somehow stop it from happening. Let's say there are, you know, like for instance, killing themselves or getting on their own. Ito yung medyo iniiwasan talaga. Actually, the beauty of the bill is it's for the students to get encouraged to study and to continue on studying without wala kang napapansin, and you can go on with your studies. Wag mong kukunin ang buhay mo ng ganun-ganun lang because somebody would take care. It's the law.
Kasama si education care. Yun, yung self-awareness, yeah. how important the person is, mm-hmm. and how they should be able to fend for themselves.
Mm-hmm. Unless the parents are the one that will get involved, it's another matter. Kasi like for instance yun sa San Agustin yun hindi na hawak ng batas yun. Penal code na yun. So yun na yung pero sa amin, as much as we could encourage the children to pursue, continue on studying regardless of mga ganitong cases, kasi may mag-handle na. So kumbaga it will be the law, the bill that will hopefully come into law na siyang magta-take care of the bully. So para hindi ka ma-disturb or whatever, hindi ka papasok sa school, hindi ka na mapakali sa school, wag na. We will stop it because the law will protect them.
Meantime, talking about timeliness, today perhaps these coming days or weeks, it will be bullying prime time. Students are coming back to school.
Yes.
And, you know, it's
a
sizing up season. No?
Yes.
Who's my next victim? So what's your advice to parents who have children coming to school tomorrow?
And may
be concerned with bullying?
If I may take muna what Teacher Joy has been teaching us as parents in their school, we should be get involved in building up or raising the character of a child. Kasi once the parents, I experienced it myself because as busy as I was, I stop and focus on the needs of my child. So parang I advise parents na somehow if they've been too busy with their works or with whatsoever, let's give time to our children. Baka kasi yun yung kailangan. Baka bago natin masolusyonan yung ibang problema ng mga companies natin, whatsoever, baka yung may problema yung ating mismo sariling. Sariling anak. So, sabi nga ni Teacher Joy, it takes a village to raise a child. Mm-hmm. So, it is yun yung essence ng ng bill na hey, parents, you should also get involved in raising up your child.
But interesting that while this bill is in progress and it is just awaiting the president's signature, when do we expect this to happen?
Well, after the passage of the bill last day of Congress, that was June 5th, 30 days on counting before
for signature. But then this obviously could be a jumping board for many other related bills, among them the Cyberbullying Act. Are you confident that perhaps this might pave the way for something like that finally?
It is also included in the cyberbullying school of the students. We're just really hopeful for the signing of the president on this bill. But we could Teacher Joy had mentioned to me while we were talking kanina that she will help me promote somehow in any ways yung paggawa ng handbook or something.
And so that comes next and many more things and projects along the way related to this bullying, anti-bullying act. On that note, thank you very much both for coming to
this
set.
Thank you.
Representative Mitch Cahayon, principal author of the Anti-Bullying Act, and Joy Cannon, psychologist and author of the Multiple Intelligence International School. Thank you both.
Thank you.
Up next, tennis star Serena Williams makes history in Paris.
And we'll take a look at the upcoming crime thriller, The Frozen Ground. Sports and entertainment on Late Line Philippines Weekend returns.